You can see here the number of members to be elected from each state has been fixed by the fourth schedule of the constitution. There are how many schedules in the Indian constitution? 12 schedules. Okay, you should remember that. How many parts are there? How many things are there? Okay, I'll put wait. Indian constitution, you write with pencil there. No, they do semi Christmas very grandly or what in the Genesis school.
The primary schools
yesterday also there was some you can note down there are 22 parts, 8 schedules. Yeah. Now there are 25 parts. One second. This is from Vedantu. It should be mostly correct. When the constitution was made, it was 8 schedules. So we have now at present there are 448 articles right there, 448 articles divided into 25 sections. Or schedules, schedules, right? Yeah, tell me. So now we have 448 articles, 25 parts, 12 schedules. Clear? So this is in which one? Fourth one. So like that, any point when we see, if you can gather full information, so any twist and turn, you can be able to attempt it. That's why we need complete details. Next. So is this point clear? The number of members shall be elected from the state has been fixed in the constitution. They'll follow the constitution. What would happen if we were to follow the American system of equality or representation in Rajya Sabha? That is your question. UP with a population of 1998. As per the statistics which are available in 1998 election data, 12 lakh would get seats equal to that of Sikkim, whose population is only 6.10 lakhs. Means in UP we have more population, in Sikkim we have less population. Okay. The framers of the constitution wanted to prevent such discrepancy. They want to prevent that. Then how? What did they do? States with the larger population will get more representatives than states with the smaller population get, because they don't want to say that for 12 lakhs one representative, for 6 lakhs one representative. It's not matching. 12 lakhs is not equal to 6 lakhs. No, there will be so many people with different issues, different concerns, so we cannot equate it. So better, if let us take the lowest one as a criteria, for every 6 lakhs if you are giving, we'll give 2 for UP, 1 for Sikkim, because people are important, not the count. So people have to be respected. So thus the more populous state like Uttar Pradesh, sends 31 members to Rajya Sabha, while a smaller state with less population like Sikkim has one seat in Rajya Sabha. So what is the criteria that we are looking at here? People, population, proportion. You can name depending on, but the ultimate thing is there should be equality, equal respect for everybody. At the same time, we cannot increase the Rajya Sabha numbers equal to Lok Sabha, no, because it's fixed in the constitution. If time comes, they may update it. That's a different case. If they feel, they will do. Then the members of Rajya Sabha are elected for a term of 6 years. So term of Rajya Sabha members is 6 years. They can get re-elected. All the members of Rajya Sabha do not complete their terms at the same time. Now, this is very, very important.
Looks like a permanent, but
empty completely. Because Lok Sabha, if Prime Minister will resign, everybody will leave. But Rajya Sabha is not like that. Yes. So let us see what is that. Every 2 years, 1/3 of the members of Rajya Sabha, they will do something. They complete their term, and elections are held for those 1/3 seats only. Now, you take here total members of Rajya Sabha 250. You divide them by 3. 3 8s are 24. 3 3s are 9. So let us say 84.33 will come. We can't divide people, so let us keep it like that. So every 2 years, 84 members will resign, or the term will complete. Then, for this 84 members only, elections will happen. Now, so let us give it a year. For example, 2021. This one. What is that term? 6 years. Means 2015, you say. 15 they got elected. They will retire. Then 2017. Another 84 will get elected. 2019. Another 84. Yeah. So here 2015 will retire in 2021. So elections will happen now. Again 84 will come. They will be till 2027. Right? Now here 2017 they come. When will they retire? 2023. Still time is there. Okay. Then these people came in 2019. 2025, still lot of time is there. So now you come to Lok Sabha elections. 2014, Narendra Modi came to power. 2019, again elections happened. Again he came to power. Again after 2024. So this house will be elected, will be dissolved, again elected, again dissolved, again elected, or term will complete. Or for all members. But here, it is not like that. If this section is moving, this section will be there, plus this section anyway will be there. But elections will be happening for every 2 years, because the cycle will be coming, no? Every 2 years you will hear Rajya Sabha elections, or every 6 years. Okay, but not for all members. That's why you get 1 seat, 2 seats, 4 seats, 5 seats, 6 seats. Like that you get. 2014, here KCR is there. He nominated somebody. His term 2020 it finished. 2018, KCR got re-elected. Again KCR is there. He will send somebody, or he can send the same person. You can get re-elected now. If he is okay with him, he will send him. If not, he will change the person. Then 2018 afterwards, again 2023 KCR should get elected, then only he will be able to do something in 2024 Lok Sabha elections and also in Rajya Sabha elections. If he is not winning also, he can win Lok Sabha elections in 2024. Are there no states which don't have power in their state but they are members in Lok Sabha? They can be, no. So this is the system. You understood? Shall we go ahead? Yeah. Thus, Rajya Sabha is never fully dissolved. Therefore, it is called a permanent house of the parliament. So you, we have write a question. Why Rajya Sabha is called a permanent house when you are writing it? The advantage of this arrangement is that even when Lok Sabha is dissolved during the time of elections yet to take place, the meetings of Rajya Sabha can be called in case of emergency, urgent businesses can be conducted. Backup plan, safe plan, safe game, plan B, because country is important, not houses. People has to be safe. In Lok Sabha also, if they dissolve also, Prime Minister will be acting as an interim Prime Minister, temporary. So he can take, if there is an emergency situation, he will take with the support of Rajya Sabha then, if needed. He can discuss in Rajya Sabha, no, then. That time we can call Rajya Sabha for suggestions, no. So apart from the elected members in Rajya Sabha, why Rajya Sabha is so powerful? Rajya Sabha also has 12 nominated members. The president nominates these members. These nominations are made from among those who have made their mark in the fields of literature. If you write a tremendous book, writing something, science, you did some invention, you are a doctor, you did some science, scientist, whatever it is. Art, you painted very nicely, it got representation for our country. So country wants to do something, you go back and teach our children, our generation, or some social service. Now they added sports also. That's why Tendulkar came. To bring Tendulkar only, they amended this. There will be amendments if you are extraordinary. I don't remember, but we can do that. We can search. So like this, in your field, if you are expert, you will be pulled out to Rajya Sabha to share your experience. Sachin Tendulkar suggested to bring sports as a curriculum, not as an extraordinary extracurricular activity, bring it as a co-curricular activity, curricular activity. Teach sports in the class as a subject. Football has to be taught to children, not to play, to understand the goal. There is a goal for everybody to reach. Not football goal. But how do you know? You will come when you play, you become better. This is what Vivekananda told, not him. Vivekananda feels whoever is playing football, they will definitely be successful. I don't know why in India we don't play football so much. You can do it alone, but only in football you need team support. Alone if you try also, somebody can stop you, no, other team can stop you. But if with the team you will do, you can win very fast. Definitely will win. See, what I understood is, Vivekananda is trying to tell, let us be as a team. Your family is your team. If father and mother doesn't support you, you can't do anything. You try, but you cannot. You go to any level, you want to travel to other country, passport. If your father doesn't give you birth certificate or 10 certificate, what will you do? You may think that I will do by myself. But if he is supporting you, you don't need to do much, he will support. It becomes easy. That's what, but things become easy. Like that. Okay, so note down the question. With pencil you note down there. There only note down there. Underline this point. So that why you put permanent house and why you write there. And in which fields they give these awards? Mark that. Quickly read about Rajya Sabha. I'll give you 2 minutes. Then we'll go to Lok Sabha. Any doubts? If you have doubts, ask. Otherwise, we'll go to Lok Sabha. Okay. Shall we go? Till 12 only I'll teach. I'll forget. Please remember. That's why I'm telling you. Last is song. Conclusion is song. Starting with song. Conclusion is song. Correctly. Homework. At home you do, because song again we don't want to miss. Before we complete the chapter, you have to submit me. That's it. Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha name. Lok, people. Hindi word. People's house. Okay. The Lok Sabha and the state legislative assemblies are directly elected by the people. That's why we are calling this as the house of the people. How they will do that? Through elections. The purpose of election is the entire country, that is state, for state legislature means. If you want to put here Lok Sabha, state assembly, you can put state. Both is divided into territorial constituencies of roughly equal population. Not exactly equal, roughly equal, generally equal. In some constituencies it can be more, some it can be less. For MLA, it is 3 lakh. For MP, it is 20 lakhs. That is a rough criteria. One representative is elected from each constituency through universal adult franchise, you know, Article 326, 18 years. All will get right to vote, irrespective of caste, color, creed, region, religion. So, here for 20 lakhs, we have one representative in Lok Sabha. Here, one representative in state assembly, Vidhan Sabha. Okay. Not exactly like that. Don't think exact. Close by. See, some border areas are there. Comes into another state. We can't divide that, no. So we may reduce it sometimes. We may add that segment to that state constituency, that state MLA house, that state MP. Don't go by the blind rules. It will not be like that. Some flexibility is required. That's why we should have lean mentality. Not firm, lean. Where you have to stand, you stand. Where you have to lean, you lean. To avoid that only, no. Yes.
Then does it half the people belong to this and half the people belong to that?
Yes.
And then they are to elect for chief minister and all this?
No. You will have only one vote. Either you take from that state or this state, depending on your house. In which state area your house is coming. I went to Bedar one time. Bedar is one place. I worked for Gurukul, Swamiyar Gurukul. So it's here. Gurukul school is here. You stand on this side, you get Andhra signal. I went from Andhra Pradesh. So I can call my parents from this side. If I go this side, I get Karnataka signal. The school is like that. The places are like that. So which area your house is coming, that state only you will get the right to vote. From that state only you will elect the MP. That state only benefits you get. Whatever. both states you will not get, because you are only one.
Yeah.
Indian constitution is only one. US constitution means dual states, dual mental, that's a different thing. No, no, you'll get one state and one national identity. US that way. But there also you don't get two states.
Yeah.
Like that. So I remember that. So if I have to call home, I used to call from this side. If I have to call from this side, then I have to use another SIM, which is Karnataka SIM. Because their Andhra signal won't come. It's like that. So you can see here where the value of vote of every individual would be equal to another. Everybody is equal. At present, there are 543 constituencies. This number has not changed since 1971 census. Maybe after 2021 census, there can be some change or some reshuffling can happen. We don't know. Yeah, this year they'll take. Every 10 years they take. COVID, COVID. You should remember that.
Yeah, but are they going to do
next year? They'll start this year or next year. They'll. Due to COVID, we could not do that. COVID has taught us some lessons, very valuable lessons, which has stopped our lives, made them forced us to think seriously and restart. Just like off. We are not dead, but we are alive, but we are stopped. We are stopped for a few months. The world was stopped, not you alone. Again, slowly new normal came. Again, it is stopped. Again, it is new normal. So, there is some serious change which is required. Some balance has to be maintained. So many people died. Course only the day. We are lucky, at least we are alive. So let's not waste any time. Lok Sabha is elected for a period for 5 years. This is the maximum. When we have learned in the chapter executive that before the completion of 5 years, the Lok Sabha can be dissolved if no party or a coalition can form the government, if the Prime Minister advises the President to dissolve Lok Sabha and hold a fresh election. Now, why he is telling this is this, that why we are saying a maximum period. Minimum period is not in our hands. It is in whose hands? Constitution is only giving you the maximum. Minimum we don't know. Let us see. There is a rule in the constitution. If a prime minister proposes a bill, if this bill is rejected in Lok Sabha for any reason, immediately Prime Minister has to resign. Yeah.
Why?
I think you did not understand what is the role of the Prime Minister.
No.
Who becomes a Prime Minister?
The most, yeah.
Means you don't have majority there.
What if the people just don't like the bill, but it's still supported?
Then they will vote no. The logic is very clear. If you are a leader, you should command majority support. People should follow you. If they are not following you, you are not a leader. No doubt. You should have to resign immediately. Arvind Kejriwal did this in Delhi first time. I don't know whether they are following this blindly or not. You can still re-put the bill, no? You can talk to them and re-put the bill again. To make sure that you pass, because you are the leader, your idea has to be valued, respected. If they don't understand, they can come to your cabin, discuss with you. they are your friends as MP. You are also MP only. They can still discuss. Yeah. So what they will do before only they'll discuss.
Yeah.
That is better. Preparation is better than disaster. Have a plan. They will plan and they will tell, this is bills we are bringing. Please support. Our friends also will support. Some 2-3 parties they'll keep ready, backup. So without any problem, bills will be passed. Even if the bill is passed, if there is some wrong element in this, or some problem is there, some issue is not addressed, it will be questioned in Rajya Sabha. Because their experts are there. Different field experts we nominated now. They'll bring out different elements in that.
So before passing that sort of bill, like that basically increase the electricity.
Yes, yes.
So didn't they think about that? Like if it goes through all this process and all?
No, no, it will be taught. See, Lok Sabha is a support house. Who is the leader? Lok Sabha generally Prime Minister is the leader. Generally they don't oppose. He's the Prime Minister. Be elected. But in Rajya Sabha, maybe they would have managed with numbers. Friends, alliances, groups, whatever it is. They'll question. In Rajya Sabha, definitely they'll question. CPI people will be there. All parties, all states will be there, no? Some states, somebody they'll question. Somehow with the numbers they managed. Then you go to Supreme Court to review it. It will check. It will appoint a committee. You're not listening. You're not listening. Once they go to Supreme Court will ask explanation from the Prime Minister's office. And also who came to the Supreme Court, they will ask them to file their obligations. It will try to balance both of them, understanding both of them. What is your thing? What is your thing? Supreme Court feels if it is justified, it says, okay, you can go ahead. If there are any recommendations, the court duty is to ensure that people are happy, guardian of the Constitution. So if it finds any difficulty in that, it will ask to recheck. Last time when the farm bills came, it clearly told, we will have to cancel this if you can't do that to the government. If you can do it, we are very happy. We will not involve in that. Because my job is not that. You try to look into this. They told you very clearly. So when it comes to reservation for VP Singh, OBC, other backward classes, right? Special economic backward classes. They need, no? They need reservation. Specially economically backward classes or socially economically backward classes. They might be OCs. They might be rich people. Community members, few may be rich. Not all. You cannot put on the name of the community saying that everybody is rich. All Brahmins are rich. Depends. We don't know. Generally, no. Few of them are rich, correct. Few are clever, correct. But because you are born in that Brahmin caste, I cannot brand you that you are rich. That is what that bill is. Socially, they are good. Socially, there is good respect. Fine. Economically, they are backward. They need to be supported. So, Supreme Court gave, don't give reservations more than 50%. You give 20%, that depends on you. Overall, SC 15, ST 10, like that overall, let us not increase more than 50%. 50% let it be reservation wise, because India is having so many castes. Fine, agreed. 50% keep it for merit. Those who are talented, let them come from any caste. That's why pass percentage is 50. For any exam. You get 50%, you are passed. 60, very good. 70, super. 90, topper. 100, don't ask. That's what court told. So, there will be solution for everything. We should look at the issue properly. What is the issue? Parliament want to address the issue of those who are socially good but economically backward. We learned about socially backward, economically backward. SC, ST, BC, OC, whatever caste you say. But here, they are born in a higher caste. That's what we felt till now. But in our country, there is an economic issue which is going during that period. They are backward now, economically. Everybody is a Indian, human first. So we should take care of everybody. Whichever caste you are, whichever category you are, whichever language you are, whichever state you are Indian. If you are an Indian, you have to be taken care of. That's what they do. That's why the bill. It's not to create any kind of trouble or any kind of, people may not understand this so clearly. That's okay. But leaders should understand this. Because next generation children should not feel bad. This generation also should not feel bad. No, they should live their life also. No. Why? Everybody has the right to live. Everybody should live happily. With dignity, with respect. Let us respect. We should respect. We'll do that. That is only our constitution. To understand only, they wrote so many big, big books so that every aspect is covered. Otherwise, no logic. Like that. Okay? Anyway. Okay, you will write here this question now with pencil, you write there. You use this line. How every individual vote is valued. How every individual vote is valued. And next question. The Lok Sabha is elected for a period of 5 years, is there now? Why? Because that is the maximum limit, no? Why? Why there is no minimum limit? You will tell that. Just why you write there, yeah, enough. Just why. Okay. Yeah. What does the parliament do? This is really good. You will make a table for this. Okay, serial number 1, 2, 3, 4, table columns, first column. Second column, you will write the function, legislative, judiciary, what? In legislative, what they will do. In judiciary, what they will do. In executive, what they will do. That's it, these three columns. And you will draw a table like this. Again, use that same thing, information, and draw a table. That's it. So, serial number, function, what? What is that function? So, you can see here, both the houses of the parliament have similar functions, not same functions. Similar, means some variation can be there. Is there a difference in the, see, is there a difference in the powers of the house? That's what we are learning. Right, apart from lawmaking, means the first function is lawmaking. Parliament is engaged in many other functions. The first function is lawmaking, it will be done in both the houses. Any laws will pass both the houses. That is the first point in the table. Okay, next. Legislative functions. The parliament enacts legislations for country. Despite being the chief lawmaking body, the parliament often merely approves legislation. There is something we have to look into. Despite being the chief lawmaking body, though they have the powers to make laws, the parliament often merely approves legislations. Simply, it will not approve any legislations, any proposals, any bills. The actual task of drafting the bills is performed by bureaucracy. Politicians will not make any laws. It will be drafted by the civil servants who are part of bureaucracy under the supervision of the minister concerned. So minister will tell the idea, legalities, technicalities, everything will be done by the IAS people, bureaucracy, not by the politician. Then the substance, once it is made, and the timing of the bills are decided by the cabinet, not by the minister. Minister may be the part of the cabinet, he may also be there, that's a different thing. No major bills is introduced in the parliament without the approval of the cabinet. Cabinet means home, finance, revenue, important key portfolio members will be there. They will decide when to get the bill. Minister will give the idea what he want to bring the change. Bureaucrats will work, they will draft the bill. That will be sent to the cabinet. Cabinet will decide when to bring this into the house. There is a process. No major bill is introduced in the parliament without the approval. Which is important bills, they don't introduce without the cabinet permission. Important changes we can't bring. Principal sir will should bring the changes. You are going for outing on 24th? You don't know? Then I'll not. Yeah. So the members other than the ministers can also introduce bills. Members other than ministers. Who are the members? The members of the parliament, not everybody in the house. Who are in the Raj Sabha or Lok Sabha? They can introduce. Anybody can introduce. Yes. But these have no chance of being passed without the support of the government. You want to bring some point to discussion, you can do that. But the bill has to be approved by government only. Later only the government. Controlling the executive and ensuring accountability. This is the second duty. First duty is legislative function. Second duty is they will control the executive, the prime minister, and ensure the executive is accountable. Where? In the parliament. Line, you tell me the line. Bureaucracy will gather the information which is needed for the bill. A bill which is approved only is called law. Without the parliament approval, it is not a law.
And they send this to the bureaucracy.
You are going wrong, the other way around. The actual task of drafting the bills is performed by bureaucracy under the supervision of the ministry concerned. The substance even the timing of the bills are decided by the cabinet. No major bills are introduced in the parliament without the approval of the cabinet. Now why will parliament come up with a bill? Yeah. Cabinet is not thinking about the bill.
Do
what?
They think about what to make the bill.
Huh.
They send that to the bureaucracy.
Huh.
The bureaucracy makes the bill.
Yes.
They send this to the cabinet. Cabinet approves.
Yes. Yeah.
And then this gets sent to the legislature.
Yes.
And all things will
approve. If it is approved, it will become an act. What is the doubt? You told correctly, you know.
Most of the work is being done by the executive. Cabinet and civil servants are part of it.
Cabinet means what you are thinking? Correct. Not Council of Ministers. Cabinet means only few key portfolio ministries.
Yeah.
3 or 4 or 5 depends. Home Minister, Finance Minister, Revenue Minister, Foreign Affairs Minister, Prime Minister will definitely be. Only these 5 are cabinet.
Huh?
What is the doubt? I'm not understanding.
It seems that most of the work is being performed by the executive rather than the minister.
No, no, no. Work they have to do, no. That's why they are ministers. No? Work as a minister they will do. To do the work, they need the permission from the house. The bills have to be approved. Even if they do the work, if the bill is not approved, the work is cancelled. No? Correct, Tulli. You are not understanding properly, or I am not understanding properly. Who is making laws?
The cabinet and the with the bureaucracy.
Who is in the cabinet?
The minister, the piece of election.
Who is the minister?
The ones with the great portfolios given by the prime.
Who will become a minister?
The ones handpicked by the prime minister to.
Whom prime minister will pick?
Left people from his party.
All members from his party can be selected?
For minister position. Not for the portfolio, only a few members.
Anything. From where he will pick? From his party?
Yeah.
Or from his party members elected to Lok Sabha? So what is their primary duty?
To govern the country.
First they are members of Lok Sabha or Raj Sabha. Yes or no? No, anybody from here will become minister. Only if you are a member of Lok Sabha or Raj Sabha only you will become minister, no? What is their primary duty? They are members of Lok Sabha or Raj Sabha, means law making only, no? You may get a post to do some work because you are party one.
Oh, so this is where those gray area sort of thing gets mixed up.
Nothing is mixed.
Like they come under both executive and legislative.
First they are legislative members, no? If you are legislative member only, you will become executive, no? You don't become from air executive, no? Huh? No, you don't become minister from bureaucracy, no?
No, we don't.
Then? You talk about one aspect.
Yes, sir.
You are talking about a minister. Cabinet ministers. Prime minister. Is prime minister a bureaucrat? What is Prime Minister?
Part of the Parliament.
Member of Lok Sabha, no?
Yeah.
Then only he became Prime Minister?
Yes.
Then only he became President or Prime Minister, whatever it is.
Yeah, I got what you're saying.
No, no. That's why he is doing this. He is given assistance because he got a position.
Yeah.
That is the purpose. Not executive is doing something. He became executive because legislature is commanding him. Whatever you will do, legislature only will decide. You cannot do anything what you want to do if you are not a member of legislature. Understood. Now you tell me again your point.
Okay, this is what I understood. So the cabinet is part of the executive, but first of all, it was part of the legislature.
Come with cabinet. First you tell who is cabinet. Then you come.
Cabinet are ministers who are picked to be part of the Lok Sabha and then further picked by the prime minister to take up few profile jobs like the home minister.
Depending on their abilities. Yeah. No, no. First Lok Sabha will elect the leader of the house.
Yeah.
Leader of the house is the one which party has majority. The party will suggest some names in their house. They will say these all are the legislative members, so they'll have like suppose Telangana meeting, Telangana Rashtra Samiti legislative party meeting, means all the elected members will meet there outside. They will decide one person name and they will go ahead. So when they go to the Lok Sabha, they will say this person we are electing as our leader. He will become the prime minister. So he will decide whom he should be in his team. Yeah. So you don't get an executive post directly like that.
Yeah.
Your qualification is member of parliament. Got the point? What is your primary duty? To make laws. That you can do without being a prime minister also. That's what they are telling, no?
Yeah.
You can introduce a private bill also to get approved. If you don't want to get approved only for discussion, then you can still instigate. No? You want a discussion on a certain issue. So nobody is discussing. You can put a private bill. The country will discuss. No? Approved or not, government will decide. Why are you worried about it? If it is about people, government will definitely do. No? If they are not doing, government will fall down. People will vote no next term. You only will become prime minister, no? It depends. So executive is not doing anything new. Party campaigning, what you did, that has to be done, means there should be a strong leader with commitment, who is also an MP. If MP only, they will become. Without MP also, we can become. Within 6 months, you should get elected to any of the house. There is a condition like that in the constitution. Is that clear now? Is that clear? Any doubts for you? Yeah. So let us go to the next point now. Controlling of the executive. We have 4 minutes, so we will finish this part and we will stop. Executive ensuring its accountability. How can it control the executive? We'll see that. The most vital function of the parliament is to ensure that the executive does not overstep its authority and remain responsible to the people who have elected them. That is the second important function. Because if you are not answering in the parliament, you will not answer anywhere else. Government will fall down. Disastrously. So it's like that. So read these 2 points quickly. 12 o'clock exactly we'll stop.